What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. I'm literally on top of the stairs watching TJ Hunt working on cars. Alex is pretending to work. What a better way to end a Sunday. It's not even Sunday, it's Monday. So what's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. So this is gonna be a little series that I'm gonna start. Any car that I personally like, it's not gonna be every single car that comes in here, but every car that I do like, or I find it interesting, or maybe I haven't shot it before, but we're pretty much almost ready for wrapping. Obviously the paint has to be prepped, the car has to be prepped, because we are not gonna wrap with, you know, obviously dirty. The car was washed before it got dropped off, which is perfect, so we don't have to do the washing, you know, section of it. But like I said, this series is specifically just for wrapping. I know a lot of people are interested in it, and a lot of people do it as a hobby. This little series, every single time I'm gonna post one of these videos, I'm gonna put at visualized wraps like at the end of it. That way you guys know this is primarily just a wrapping video. We're still gonna be talking maybe about builds on the side, but we're mainly focusing on just either the customer's cars, the homie's car, or whatever car I'm showing you at that time. Let me talk about the mods that he's done so far. Maybe we'll do like a little feature once it's like completely done on the actual, like make it like an actual vlog. But he does have an engine intake, coilovers. Do you know the brand of them? Because I don't remember if he said. Let's put a little pin on it. I'm not too sure which coilovers he got, but he did get coilovers, and it did drop it a good amount. And I feel like this ride height is pretty nice, especially once he gets like his actual wheels and everything. It's gonna look really, really nice. It's sitting nice and low. Cool, now I'm over here. Yeah, so we took off the whole door just to get to the mirror, and then we're gonna figure out this, because we're still working on it. But this is what he also got, the forged carbon. It is wrapped, but it looks stupid crazy. Like, it looks legit.
Looks really good.
So he has that in the interior. I totally forgot about the exhaust. As in NVIDIA, is it a cat-back exhaust?
No, I think it's an axle-back.
Just axle-back.
Is it? Yeah, it should be an axle-back.
It's nice. So I think that's pretty much all the mods the car has, but like I said, it's just gonna get super crazy once you get this wheel set up. His bags are just gonna change the car dramatically. Let's go ahead and get started. Like I said, we're literally watching like other YouTubers while we're gonna start wrapping the car. I'm gonna start prepping probably the front, and I'm gonna show you guys what I do to prep the like each panel. So obviously the car came in washed, but normally we wash it. So let's look at some of our products that we have here. Normally I use this one, the Citrus Washing Gloss by Chemical Guys. This is usually a pretty good one, but this is going to be like our first step that we do. But obviously he washed it himself, so we're going to skip that, and then we jump right into our own version of a soap blend. So we use our own version of soap blend, get the panels nice and clean, which actually I already started with the first panel, so we're going to go into the second step. Our second step is usually going into a wipeout, which is a surface cleaner. So this removes every little thing, wax, polish, like all that stuff. It completely removes it. So we're gonna go ahead and hit our panel with our wipeout. Okay, so like I said, this is basically part three, which is the wash, our soap blend that we use to remove any kind of little dirt. And then now we're gonna hit it with the wipeout. We're gonna go ahead and just kind of hit it with nice little, not too much, because we definitely don't want to get it super soaked wet, because obviously on the little cracks and stuff like that we have to wrap in, we don't want the wrap touching it, because obviously it won't stick to it. Cool, all the dirt and debris and everything that was around it, the wipeout definitely took care of it. But obviously our body panels are not ready for wrap, because if you hear that, yeah, that's not good. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go over here, pick up our clay luber, look for the right clay bar to use, because there's different levels to it. There's low, medium, and aggressive. The way we usually pick them up, and they come in these nice little boxes in our Kimmo. Guys, we're gonna be using the light one because it's not really that much that we really have to work with. Okay, so now that we have our panel right here, we're gonna be using our clay luber and our clay bar. I'm pretty much gonna mist it again, and then just kind of go around and get the panel nice and smooth. And I'm gonna show you guys like the difference, but remember the sound, because it's definitely not gonna sound like that anymore. So look at that shine already. Like we've done a good amount on the paint. Look, nice and smooth. You literally can't hear anything. Nice and smooth. Literally all the panels nice and smooth. Remember how it sounded? Use my other hand because I don't want to mess it up. But look, nice and smooth. You don't hear anything. Look at the reflection. Sheesh. Should we be detailers? And last but not least, I'm gonna go ahead and hit the fender with some rubbing alcohol. Literally just getting it the last bit. Is it a lot of parts? Yes. Do we care? No. Because at the end of the day, this panel, I know for a fact, is nice and cleaned up and the prep is amazing. Like, you know? So I don't really care that it's a lot of, like, parts. Because, yes, it gets kind of, like, annoying that I have to do every single body panel like this. But at the end of the day, it's just, like, more peace of mind that the panel's going to be good. And I'm not going to have any issues where it not grabbing on. Or the wrap's not grabbing onto the panel or something like that. So I'm finally ready to start wrapping. And a quick little tip for anybody that's trying to wrap their car at home. Like if you literally get the rag, it doesn't matter if it's like with alcohol or soap, but just kind of hit like all these little corners. We see all this dust. All this is going to pick up when you start laying the panel down. And all this is going to get underneath the wrap. So like literally just clean it up. This is kind of dirty. This is literally on top of it. So all the dust is going to be falling off. So literally just clean up this little section here. This little section here, this section here. A little bit of the pillar, a little bit of this door, some side skirt. And depending how dirty or how you have your setup at home, if you wet the floors, this stops any kind of debris to fly up. Hit the rim a little bit, hit this up here. You know, I probably overdid it a little too much, but this is a good amount. This is a good amount that when we lay our panel, there's no debris around there, there's no dust that's gonna get stuck underneath, creating those little like dots on underneath the wrap. And then the floor is nice and wet, so we're literally ready to wrap.
Apple gone.